is the book of Hebrews 6 and 17. Get right to the point wherein the Heavenly Father, or God, which his name is Yahweh, his son's name is Yahweh Shai, wherein God willing more abundantly to show unto the heirs of promise. Who's that? That's the nation of Israel, beginning with the elect. The heirs of promise. Heir means someone who's set to inherit something. The first thing we're going to inherit, those of us that are part of the elect, is salvation by Yahweh Shai into those chariots. Then we're going to inherit those new bodies that the Apostle Paul talked about. As a matter of fact, the Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians 15, we shall be changed in the twinkling of an eye. Like that, we're going to get these new indestructible bodies. In other words, we're never going to die. Death is going to be a thing of the past. So we're going to be like gods. Psalms 82 and 6. You know, we're going to have godlike powers in the flesh. We're going to have godlike powers in the flesh. I just gave you a couple of examples of what we're set to inherit. That's why it says ears of promise.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 46, verse 1. Baal bowed down, Nabooth stoopeth. Their idols were upon the beast and upon the cattle. Your carriages were heavy loaden. They are a burden to the weary beast. First and foremost, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory unto Yahweh. Baruch Hashem Yahweh Shah, Baruch Hashem Kakadash. Double honors unto the apostles and the elders of GMS, whom rule well, teach well, being great examples to his younger brothers. And peace and blessings and salutation to the whole lake out there pushing his word and truth and in sincerity across the four winds in the name of Yahweh Baruch Hashem Yahweh Shah. Pushing to get up out of here. Shalom to the whole lake, the believers, the listeners, whom have came back to the obedience of the scriptures through faith in Yahweh Baruch Hashem Yahweh Shah. And what I want to get into, okay, this morning is dealing with how the culture that comes with idol worship, okay, which dominates this society today, you know, has become a burden to the people. Okay, and see, one thing about it, once you continue to stray away from the righteousness of the scriptures, okay, it becomes a point to where it doesn't even make sense anymore. It becomes a burden. Okay, that's why you see people are complaining, but this is under the rulership of pagan rulers. Okay, of a nation of people. All right, these Edomites that worship Satan. Okay, they're all into witchcraft and paganism and idolatry and, you know, left hand energy. Okay, left hand spirits, you see. And there's a doctrine that comes with these things, and that's the doctrine that dominates the earth, and mainly, all right, within the form of westernization. Okay, where pretty much they say you're liberated, but liberated to do what? Okay, be wicked, you see. And this culture has become a burden to the people that worship you, man. Okay, and when you read Isaiah 46 and 1, it says, bow down, Nabooth stoopeth. Their idols were upon the beast and upon the cattle. Your carriages were heavy loaden. They are a burden to the weary beast. Okay, and you read in the NLT, it says Baal and Nabooth, the gods of Babylon. Okay, which, hey, we're in the daughter of Babylon, which is America. It says bow as they are lowered to the ground. They are being hauled away on ox carts. The poor beasts stagger under the weight. And the poor beasts in this time would be the people, because this is what upholds the people, uphold this culture, okay, of paganism, idolatry, self-worship, woman worship, you know, idolizing, you know, material things, you know. Under this burden, I mean, the people represent the beast as they're bearing the burden of these idols, man. Okay? Materialist culture, people trying to keep up with everyone, you know. It's a burden to try to stay trending. Okay, it's a burden, you know, to try to look a certain way or dress a certain way according to this world standards, man. Okay, And seeing the people are being broken down, the people are becoming depressed, you know? And they say since social media came out, depression has went through the roof because people are comparing themselves to other people's lives. And, you know, then the lives they comparing to, they lying, you know? So it's all a mess of confusion, man. Okay? The women, you know, trying to live by this feminist, strong, independent narrative is becoming a burden to them. They're crying out. You see? It's a burden. The men, okay, leaving, you know, getting passports, leaving because the women have become a burden. You know, the modern woman has become a burden. You see? Jake trying to keep up with the Joneses, trying to give the woman everything she wants. You know, she has this materialistic mind frame, trying to give her everything she wants. Okay? It's a burden. There's a lot of men that are burdened by these modern marriages, man. Okay? And it all goes back to idolatry, man. Okay? Trying to appease the queen of heaven. Okay? It's become a burden. You see? Verse 2, it says, they stooped down together. They could not deliver the burden, but themselves are gone into captivity. And see, people have become a slave to the thought process of this system, man. Like I say, when you're trying to keep up with the Joneses, okay, when you're trying to portray, all right, this life of prosperity to everyone 24/7, okay, as a woman, you know, that's why you have women even going to get these surgeries, because they trying to, you know, keep up with the status, okay, of what a woman should look like compared to this society. Okay, and you go into, you know, those shapes that those women, you know, are trying to get. It goes back to different goddesses, okay, of these heathens, man. All right, Diana, Ephesus, okay, all, you know, Black Madonna, all these different goddesses of the heathen, Il Nana, okay, Diva, you know, it's a goddess of Diva, you know, going back to Elam. Okay, and you have these women that go get their surgery, okay? Why, man? You see, it all goes back to the culture that comes with idol worship. You see, and people have gone into captivity under these cultures, man. Okay, and that's why Yahweh said this in the book of Matthew 11. Okay, Matthew 11, okay, and 28, it says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. You see, we have a rest, okay, there's a rest that comes with not living by the narrative and the culture, okay, of paganism, of idols, okay, you see, we don't live by that standard anymore, okay? And there's a rest that comes with that, okay? We're not trying to keep up with this society. We're not trying to chase what this world calls prosperity, okay? We're content with, you know, the situation that we're in, okay? You know, we make a move here and there to, you know, better our situation, but that ain't what makes us, man, okay? We're focused on spiritual things now, you see? It says, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your souls. Okay? We have found rest unto our souls because we came away from under that burden, that captivity of this westernized culture, man. You know, which is always, you know, pushing the standard. You should be like this. You should look like this. You should have this. At this age, you should be here. At this age, you know. All these different standards and burdens that they put on this society, okay, and that pushes the masses to depression. But see, we have so much to look forward to in the kingdom to come, to where the things of this kingdom really don't move us. We become dead to this society, man. Okay, you got people disappointed because they didn't get the Valentine gifts that they want. That's a captivity, man. People are in captivity to Christmas, where you go in debt to try to, you know, keep up with the gifts that you see people getting on Facebook, okay, Instagram. That's a burden. Your man has to, you know, find a way to make his house have this perfect Christmas. That's a burden, man. Okay, we don't have those burdens anymore, man. Okay, we have rest. Okay, you see, we have rest now. All right, we have a different standard that we're living up to, man. It said, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Okay, because even like, you know, sisters that have repented, you know, trying to live by that strong black woman narrative, I know it's a rest, you know, when you're not living by that anymore, man. And the Lord is building up men, you know, that these women can come up under, you know, and get some rest and get some relief, you see, and they just get to flourish in their role as women, okay, instead of trying to have to be the man and the woman, you know, the provider, the protector, the nourisher, you know, the breadwinner, the this and that, okay, there's a rest, okay. But what's happening, and see, Eastern, Western culture is being cursed out in the earth. Like, you know, people are realizing, like, man, this ain't it, man. Okay? It got to be a better way. And we found it through Yahweh Shai. This is Jeremiah 50:1. It says, the word that the Lord spake against Babylon and against the land of the Chaldeans by Jeremiah the prophet. Declare ye among the nations and publish and set up a standard. See, a standard has been set up. So now we have a standard to compare, okay, this current society to. You see, we have a standard of righteousness now from the scripture. So when we compare the two, we like, damn, you know, this is off as hell. You see? And it says, publish and conceal not. Say, Babylon is taken, Baal is confounded. Okay? Merodach is broken in pieces. Her idols are confounded. Her images are broken into pieces. Okay? So what's happening? The image of this society is being confounded. Okay? You go here to confound it. Okay? The Lord is breaking this place up. Okay? He's making the wise seem very foolish. Okay, you go into the word confounded, all right, and you go here to the strong definition. It says to be ashamed, confused, or disappointed. Okay, look what idolatry, okay, the culture that comes with idolatry, look at the confusion it has people in, man. Okay, you had that woman, Ketanji Jackson, you know, the nigga woman that's a Supreme Court judge. They asked her what a woman was, and she couldn't answer. She's confused because this culture, and you know, it has just destroyed, okay, the righteous standard that was set up from the beginning. Okay, you got to call one person them and us. That's confusion. Okay, people getting surgery trying to change, you know, their genders and, you know, confusion. You see, you look at these current marriages, it's confusion. The woman don't know her role, the man don't know what to do, the children, okay, have the option to change their gender. You know, it's just confusion. It's being confounded. It's not working. Marriages are trash under this under this culture, man. Okay, marriages are miserable, man. Marriages are supposed to be a joyful thing, a peaceful thing. Okay? But under this society, it's miserable. You see? Why? Because of the culture, man. That stems from idolatry, man. Well, see, the Lord is breaking it up. Okay? By establishing a righteous standard in the earth, man. Okay? Disappointed says to be ashamed, confused, or disappointed. And because like a lot of women, you know, as you ask, you know these different, you know, these little talk shows, these little podcasts and talk shows they got, and you can see, like, when they ask women how many kids they got, you know, and they throw the number out, but then we ask them, well, how many different men, you can feel, okay, the shame, you know, okay, you know, to the point where some women even lie, you know, because it's, hey, this culture has led to a shame, okay, and then you have men, okay, that are deadbeats, okay, they're ashamed to even tell you they got kids because they ain't doing nothing for them, so, but why, it all goes back to idolatry, man, okay, and the culture that stems from it, okay, then plus you have our people under the curses, so it's magnified, man. You see? Alright, so the chief idols, you know, which represent the chief ideologies that run this society, the daughter of Babylon, is being confounded, man. Okay? And the West is being completely confounded. Alright? You know, Psalm 79, it says, oh, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end. You see? And that's why the Lord is breaking this place up. He's breaking up these ideologies that run the earth. They're being confounded. Okay? They're being made to look, all right, extremely stupid, man. It says, but establish the just, all right, for the righteousness, for the righteous power, drive the hearts and the reins, which is your mind. Okay, so the Lord is breaking up the wicked, causing it to come to an end. Okay, because this way is not, see, the culture that stems from idolatry will never, all right, have an influence in the earth again. It's going to be cut off. Okay, it's going to be done. It's going to be finished. You see, and these are the times that we're coming into. Okay, where the Lord is confounding this place, man. Okay. The ways of the wicked would not be established, okay, in the earth. Okay, when you read the book, you go into Proverbs 10. Alright, and 24. It's Proverbs 10 and 24. It says, the fear of the wicked, it shall come upon him, but the desires of the righteous shall be granted. Okay, so the wicked fear of going, you know, of being removed from power. Okay, they fear of them not having influence in the earth anymore. But that's going to happen. The Lord is going to confound them. You see, but he's going to establish righteousness eternally. Okay, and this is what the time we're coming into, man. So we're in the transition of kingdoms, okay, and this culture, all right, Westernization, this society, has become a burden to the people, okay, but it's still all they know, and they're always trying to find some comfort, even within the oppression of this society. And a lot of them are going to choose the beast, okay, and be destroyed. So, Lord will. You know, this is edifying once again. We'll give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushua, Bahashem, Kakadash, and double honors unto the apostles and the elders of GMS who rule well, teach well, being great examples towards younger brothers, and peace and blessings, salutations, and hopefully, Shalom.